The following is a presentation of The Day.
On a warm Tuesday in March, where thoughts are turning to the spring, basketball takes center stage and a battle for the top spot is imminent, and you're going to see it all live on Game Day. Game Day is brought to you by Waterford Dental Health. At Waterford Dental Health, our entire team is dedicated to providing you the personalized, convenient, and affordable dental care you and your family deserve. Casey O'Neill, along with the sports doctor, Keith O'Brien, and, you know, this is the game we were waiting for teams to shake out. We were kind of waiting to figure what would happen, and now all of a sudden, this is the game that people want to see, and you got a NFA basketball.
Yeah, NFA and East Lyme. I'm not going to discriminate here, Casey, but, you know, 5-6-1 East Lyme team coming in red hot, smoking guns, taking on a 5-2 NFA team. And if you talked about the game of the league in the year, this could be it tonight.
This is the game we've wanted to see as the teams have matured and sort of gelled. No one's been able to really figure out the NFA 3-2 zone. They've started playing really good basketball. East Lyme, Jeff Bernardi said it's the best defensive team he's ever had. They throttled Waterford the other night. And this is going to be a good test because these are, I think, the two best defensive teams in the league.
Right, and probably the two most disciplined teams in the league. Two teams are very well coached, Casey. And just, it's going to be a great matchup from top to bottom.
Well, a special event here tonight honoring retiring coach Chris Giusti.
COVID-19, and the world has been turned upside down ever since. Tonight, we'd like to attempt to put a closure to a miraculous season put forth by the NFA boys basketball team. At the time of the shutdown, the NFA boys were 23-0 and about to begin their state tournament run. The shutdown left more questions than answers for the year. We will never know what could have been. Tonight, we'd like to recognize Coach Chris Giusti for making the NFA basketball record book in two areas. Presenting plaques to Coach Giusti this evening is NFA's athletic director, Mr. Roy Wentworth. The first plaque is for the best single season record in NFA history of 23-0. And the second plaque being presented to Coach Giusti is for tying the regular season win streak mark at 25 games. Congratulations to Coach Giusti, his staff, and the entire NFA boys basketball program.
And not only is he the premier coach with the awards tonight, the best dressed guy in all the land, rocking the bow tie, the white pants, Chris Giusti. Look at that, resplendent, he's owning it tonight.
Yeah, he looks terrific, Casey. And again, you talk about a young man, or I call him a young man because everybody's young to me. Just done a great job taking over from Neil Carlin and carrying on the tradition here. And he has put his own stamp onto this program. That's for sure.
You know, he's been great with us.
Yeah, tremendous.
He's been great with the kids. And I think last year, you know, that season that they had that was cut short, 23-0, what could have been? We would have loved to have seen the run. It's good that he's honored tonight. But he has a team now, and we're going to talk a little bit about them as the starting lineups get announced. What we saw the night of the Fitch game,
right,
and where they are on their road now.
He's had a team, Casey, that's had to grow and respond. And I think if you asked him, he's happy with the growth and the response he's gotten out of kids. From adversity, missing your best player, Casey, other kids rallying up. And the growth of his team has been tremendous. You look at Joe Click, you look at Pierre-Louis, some of these other players he's got over there. So if you're asking for growth and response, he's gotten that out of this group this year. They're better now than they were in, say, game two or three.
Absolutely, and we're going to break them down a little bit more after the national anthem.
At this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your hats as we honor America and the men and women who protect our freedom with the singing of our national anthem. Ooh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what's so proud?
So, you know, before the season started, Sports Doctor, we were talking about Jared Martin as a potential, maybe, you know, best player, player of the year kind of candidate. Obviously went through some some ups and downs and missed a game here and there. Now he's back, not in the starting lineup,
right,
which I think is indicative of a agreement between coach and player that
sure.
the team is bigger than any one person. And yep. I think it's a really interesting role because you could argue that preseason the most important player to NFA was Jared Martin. And as of a couple weeks ago, the emergence of Joe Klick, now they're both yeah. coming off the bench, which makes this a deeper team. But that night against Fitch, we saw them play their grit game, the gel game, the game
rally.
That brought
they
them together.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, and then they worked it out.
So I believe that the highest ceiling in the league is NFA.
All right.
I believe the highest floor in the league is East
yeah,
Lyme,
East
which
Lyme.
Means if these two teams both play average, East Lyme wins. But if NFA plays best and East Lyme plays their best, I think NFA is the team that wins this game.
Straight up man-to-man defense here by East Lyme, Case.
Up ahead it goes to Gaeta, and a turnover right away.
Talk about growth and response from this NFA team this year. How about development for Jeff Bernardi and his team? You know, talked about his kids last year, Casey, being part of an undefeated JV season. Now they're thrown into the limelight. They've developed just nicely.
Goose hops in with the steal and loses the ball. It's tipped around and out of the pack. East Lyme will recover. Velacos. Bounce pass nicely. Gaeta spins, jump hook in the lane. Rebound tipped. Gaeta gets his own rebound and put back for two.
Kid can go to work, can he? Just 35, just has a nose for the basketball. Just gets himself in position, hustles. Tough two at the rim.
All right, both teams need to create some offense off of turnovers,
yep.
off of transition. Outlaw loses the ball. Carpenteri underneath. Velakis can't finish. Tipped out of bounds. Roger Warner says, NFA basketball. Andy Kane and Roger Warner, your two officials tonight. And then
didn't
here
take
come
too
the
long.
Go.
Did it? Here comes Judge Klick and Martin.
Replacing guard and Biggin. Outlaw and Boone will have a seat.
Three turnovers on NFA, Casey, on the offensive end. Almost four at his backcourt. Called four.
Yeah, one thing East Lyme does so well is they anticipate passes and they get in those passing lanes. You can't move the ball around the perimeter against East Lyme.
Right, you talk about, you know, you want to try and create easy offense, and also you want to beat that NFA zone from getting a chance to set up.
There was the attempt to get a Gaeta high post, but Pierre-Louis with a interception, rather. Martin now, straightaway three, no good off the side of the rim. Tipped, Martin gets the rebound, throws it up. No good, and now stripped, and a finish by Max at the rim.
Well, Martin doing some dirty work there with the strip, keeping the play alive, and NFA gets on the board with a quick two. Martin may have forced those first two shots, just trying to get his feet wet a little bit.
I already like how East Lyme is attacking the zone, though. They're the first team that's gotten the ball into the zone twice now. Martin stutter steps, wisely pulls it out. Athletic drive to the basket. Jaden Francis hanging in the air.
You're going to hear Jeff Bernardi all night yelling, patience, patience.
I love what they have, though, with Gaeta. There's the attack by Velacos, pulls up. A flop by Francis, and Klick gets the rebound. Martin looks for the screen from Klick. Loses it out of bounds. It'll be off East Lyme. We were watching in the pregames, Joe Klick throwing it down.
Yeah.
Like
Duncan.
Like me on a Nerf hoop.
Sure. He is a specimen out there, number 21.
Do you know how dangerous I was on a six-foot Nerf hoop? I mean, I could do things on a six-foot Nerf hoop that you have never seen before.
Air O'Neill at its best.
I would play on a six-foot Nerf hoop with seven-foot ceilings. Anyone tall was at a disadvantage. We're going to get a foul on a reach, and I think they're going to get Velacos banging into Klick. Now, I've talked to some East Lyme people, and they say that the development of Matt Velacos and him coming back with the physical strength that
sure.
he came back with. He was kind of a string beanie young underclassman. Came back strong and has allowed him to really do a lot of things on versatility-wise defensively.
Yeah, both ends of the floor.
That's
offensively
right.
too, yeah. That's a good point.
It makes this starting unit for East Lyme physical, because Goose is physical, Velakos is physical, they got Anglin's physical, so it makes them a lot more of a sort of team that can beat you in multiple ways defensively. They can pressure, they can rebound, they're strong, they're long.
Good defense here by East Lyme, Casey. Switching everything on the high ball screen.
Francis, no good. Now Velakos will rebound and push. Crossover. Left-handed, no good. But look at Gata battling underneath, and Velakos, both of them. Wise choice to pull it out in a high screen. Underneath, Goose. Good patience from the Vikings.
This game could be played in the 30s tonight.
This is where NFA has to be careful. Martin, just too much dribbling. No good. Rebound, Velakos pushing. Ahead it
got
goes.
Got numbers.
Gata wisely pulls it up. But that's that NFA offense that we can't, that we saw,
right.
that not everyone's touching the basketball.
Can't have that. And, you know, the thing, too, with having Gata at the high post, Casey, is he's a threat. You know, we talk about moving players to the high post just to move him there, but he can do a little bit of everything. So when he demands that attention, that's when you can crack that zone a little bit. There you see it.
That's a great pass by Anglin, but an even better job by Francis taking the charge. And Gata rolled to the basket. That was beautifully done by East Lyme, and great defense. That's where you have a nice chess match going on each side.
Sure, and you know, we've harped on this during a couple times that we've seen NFA bring somebody to the high post. Well, here's a kid that knows what to do with the ball at the high post, and he can slip to the basket like you saw there. He picked up the charge.
Mask break, 4-2 NFA. You're watching Game Day live on theday.com. Production of The Day Publishing Company. If you'd like to support Game Day and help us continue to bring you the best in Connecticut high school sports, please consider purchasing a print or digital subscription to The Day at theday.com/subscribe. So, as always, we want you at home to let us know, where are you watching the game? Send us a photo on Facebook or Twitter, because you know what, Sports Doctor? We want to know who has the best virtual fan section out there.
Mm-hmm.
Send us a photo on Facebook or Twitter at Game Day CT, and we're going to include you in the broadcast. 4-2 NFA as we come back from mask break number one. Chris Giusti.
Dressed for success.
Pierre Louis got his first break. All the way to the basket is Spruill, blocked by Gata.
Not on my watch.
Velakos zips ahead, but Goose can't handle it. Click can't handle it. Now, I don't want to say anything. Click's an offensive lineman, but Goose is a goalie. Just catch the ball, Goose. I don't expect the offensive lineman to be able to catch the basketball.
But East Lyme will make a concerted effort, Casey, to beat NFA up the floor every time they can.
Little jump shot, no good. Martin stripped, ball on the floor, and out of the pack. NFA will have the basketball. Grover Boone. Now Click. There's a good physical battle. Click backs in Goose, hangs in the air, and can't get the soft touch.
And block is strong on the boards, Casey, for Jeff Bernardi. One and done situation for the Wildcats.
Nice, there goes Gata. There's the kick in reverse. Back to Gata, he just got bumped by Click, no call. Boone the other direction. And we're gonna get an offensive foul as Boone went hard, and there was Will Anglin to take the charge.
You know, we're gonna have some catch and shoot situations here for East Lyme from that, you know, 8 to 10 foot jump shot. That extra pass that time was costly. Turn around, rise up, and hit that jump shot.
Rowan Mundell into the ball game. He'll give Velakos a breather. Now, this is where East Lyme gets a little smaller when Mundell comes in the game and Velakos comes out of the game. So let's see what that does to their offense. There's the opportunity to get it in to Gata in a scoring position. There's a jump of a good job by Boone up ahead. Can't finish, but there's Martin, and he gets the soft roll. like Terrace Bakery. Dump down. Gata goes to his left, and there's a kick. Three ball is good.
Yeah, good basketball there. Good recognition by Gata, the drive and kick, the stick for three for East Lyme.
Will Anglin that time had a little daylight, knocked it down, and that's huge. When Gata recognizes and kicks it out, yeah, someone's got to make shots.
Textbook inside-outside basketball.
Martin gets the screen from Click. Step back three. Short. Rebound Anglin. Pushes it up ahead. Now Mundell.
I think that's a shot East Lyme will give Martin all night long. All night long.
I love how much.
No size now up front. Now you got Boone up front in that zone. Let's expose it a little bit with Gata.
And Gata gets, there it is. One-on-one with Outlaw. Kick out. Back to Goose. Nice touch pass to Mundell. They're swinging it. Good ball movement by the Vikings. And there's the patience.
That foul line area will be exposed right now if East Lyme can take advantage of it.
Now that was tipped off of NFA, so that should stay here with East
right.
Lyme. But Gata that time tried to find a cutting Viking to the basket, and I think maybe a little bit of a force job. This is, you don't want to attack the zone in the corners there.
That's no.
It's a tough trap. If you talk to Chris Giusti tonight, I want you to ask him. I know it's gauche to wear white after Labor Day, but how early before Labor Day are you allowed to wear white? It's a little early here, not even spring.
Ah, yes.
Winter white for Giusti. Martin hangs, floater, and a soft touch for Jared Martin.
Now that's coming in the natural flow of the game, young man. Get on your horse and run. Martin at the rim.
Gata, that's the shot he needs to knock down, and he does on cue.
On cue, yeah. That's textbook basketball right there. That'll bring that defense out even more, exposing the baseline.
I know he wants to get to the rim because he likes scoring around
yeah.
the basket. But
got to knock down that shot.
He has to knock down that shot. 1 point NFA lead, looking like they're going to try to hold it for the last shot. Boone, kick, out low, baseline, short, tipped, and now out of the pack come the Vikings. 4 seconds. Mundell, corner, Gata, three, no good off the side of the rim. 8-7 NFA, you're watching Game Day live on theday.com.
Okay, class, what do you want to be when you grow up? Jace.
I want to be a YouTuber.
I want to be a ballerina.
I want to be an astronaut.
I want to be homeless.
I want to hear scary voices no one else can hear.
I want to be addicted to drugs.
I want to be an actress.
I want to be a YouTuber.
I want to be an astronaut. I want to be a football player. I want to be an astronaut.
Not one child has dreams of these things becoming a reality. Sometimes choices are set before we even have a voice.
With Sound Community Services, I found my voice.
NFA at the end of the first quarter here at NFA, and the sports doctor is going to talk with NFA head coach and tonight's honoree, Chris Giusti.
Hi, Juice. Listen, 8-7. They seem to crack your zone a little bit in that first quarter. How do you keep Gata out of that high post?
I mean, actually, I respectfully going to disagree a little bit. I thought that was one of the best defensive quarters we've had all season. You know, we gave up one. We gave up that one time to Gata, but they're taking the shots we want them to take. Their defense is as good as advertised, though, so we got to get better on offense.
How do you jumpstart your offense?
You know, we just got to be patient. We came out a little jittery, turned the ball over a couple times, so, you know, we just got to settle in and know that they are going to play hard. We got to take what's open and not just force things.
Good luck, Coach.
Thanks.
Thank you, Coach Giusti, sports doctor. East Lyme going to inbound right here in front of us. I want to thank Andy Kane holding the ball for us to get let Juice get his... Underneath, Gata gets it in the high post, kicks it. Velacos high, arcing three, no good. But a ugly shot turns into a long rebound, and Gaeta will control it. I mean, the book on East Lyme is let him shoot it. You know, let him shoot it. Riley Walsh will knock some shots down, but otherwise you got to let him shoot it. There's a steal from Pierre-Louis. And Martin will control along with Tyler Spruill. Francis now to Outlaw in the high post, and he'll go over to Spruill. Spruill drives, hangs, floats, no good. Outlaw picks it up. He can't finish, and a weak side rebound to Riley Walsh. Walsh with a long three, no good, back iron, rebound, Spruill. Martin, quick trigger three, in and out, no good, rebound, Valakas. Up ahead to Walsh. Pierre-Louis got the body, and Walsh will go to the line to shoot two.
And much better job, too, Casey, by East Lyme crashing the boards on the defensive end. You don't see a lot of those second-chance opportunities that Martin had earlier. One-and-done situation. Get on the break, beat that defense down the floor, and give yourself a chance at least to score on some free throws.
So I like Juice. He said, I'm going to respectfully disagree, sports doctor, which you know.
It'll be the first time.
I'd like to say, well, listen, with all due respect, you don't know what you're talking about. But what you said was interesting. They didn't crack the zone for baskets, which was his point. What they did do was get the ball into the zone better than any team we've seen this year against them. But I think his point was so
yeah,
what?
Yeah, they got one bucket off it. Yeah. So what, yeah. Yep. Hey, I mean, listen, it won't be the first time somebody disagreed with me.
I disagreed with you before you even came in the gym
every
tonight.
Every play, yeah. It's East Lyme is going to be hanging around, Casey, up 9-8 right now.
Martin pulls it out. East Lyme, as good as advertised defensively, Coach Giusti said. Good ball movement. Pierre-Louis can't knock it down. And Valakos with what appears to be his 27th rebound of the first quarter, or the second quarter, rather.
Bad turnover by Valakos.
Martin pulls up three. Good. J-Mart Shoppers, attention.
7 points for the first man off the bench for Chris Giusti.
Gaeta forced it.
And back-to-back turnovers by East Lyme. Not good.
Spruill to Martin.
Jeff's going to call a timeout.
And Bernardi wants a timeout. NFA has opened up a four-point lead. And this is the NFA team I talked about. When Martin plays the role that he's supposed to play, which is not everything flows through him, but instead he flows
right
in the game.
Right. You know, the pull-up three came in a natural rhythm that time, the leak out, the back-to-back turnovers, and automatically get a 5-0 run when they call a timeout.
I don't want to put any blame on this, but that run coincided directly with you changing masks. Sports Doctor now has the
East
Lyme
mask on. I've got the East Lyme mask on, yeah.
And the second that happened, I mean the second it went around the ear loop,
NFA got hot.
5-0 run for NFA.
So what should am I jinxing the Vikings?
I don't believe in that, Sports Doctor. I know, but if you can sleep at night.
A little salt over my shoulder, Odie, and St. Patrick's Day's coming up.
If you can sleep at night knowing that you might have single-handedly ruined East Lyme's chances, then, I mean, that's, you know, that's on you.
Is Mike DeMauro laughing underneath his mask? Yes, he is.
So.
Now, here you go, Casey. This is a bad turnover and defense leading to some easy offense. The turnover by Gaeta in the high post, Outlaw, Martin on the break, and a finish at the rim for two.
And that's what we talked about. Both teams need to get out and get some transition baskets because both teams are too good defensively. Mm. And quite frankly, neither team is a juggernaut offensively.
Not in a half-court set.
Not
in a half-court set.
So these guys really need to – I mean, really, I think this is why Martin is the difference maker. He's a pure scorer shooter.
Sure.
East Lyme doesn't really have that from the outside. Quick trigger, Carpenteri no good, and look at Pierre-Louis go up and get the rebound. Martin, straightaway three, short rim, and we're going to get a pushing foul underneath. And a call a foul on 23? On Anglin?
I don't know.
I think they called it on Anglin. And Goose will check back in, and he will replace Gaeta. So for the next couple of minutes, take a look and see where the East Lyme offense comes from.
Yeah, it's got to probably come from
Galakis.
Long three by Martin, no good. Rebound Francis, second rebound, no good. Tipped and in. I'm going to give
Martin.
That. Yeah, I'll give it to him.
Martin's hustling. 11 out of NFA's 15 for number 11, Jared Martin.
Balakos kicks. Carpenteri for three, no good, in and out. Outlaw with a strong rebound. Martin Fancy gives it to Pierre-Louis on the baseline. Swings.
Good ball movement here by the Cats, Casey.
Francis drives, left-hander is good.
Yep. Good move that time by Francis. Again, the movement, the weaving, the passing, spreading East Lyme's defense out. No time for help. Francis delivers at the rim. Good set that time by the Wildcats. Juicy's fired up.
He's
there.
Roaming the sidelines right now. He feels it. There's a reach in and a steal by Francis. Everything going East Lyme's to East Lyme's detriment. Everything going in the favor of the Wildcats right now. Martin from the parking lot, in and out. Rebound Velakis. East Lyme's going to look to run, and we're going to get a touch foul by Martin. And I think Coach Giusti is going to have a little chit-chat with Jared Martin.
Yep. Well, 9-2 runs start the quarter, if I'm not mistaken, by NFA.
And I'm not going to blame the NBA any more than I'm going to blame, you know, Marilyn Manson for the, you know, issues of children. But I watched Steph Curry and Damian Lillard shoot the ball as soon as they stepped
Wait,
over half court.
You were one of the three people to watch that?
Absolutely. What else was I going to watch?
Paint dry.
So I watched them do that. But to me, it's an, you know, kids want to do that stuff because they want to show their range. You know what? Understand the flow of the game. That's not the shot you need. Hanging in the air and finishing at the basket is Will Anglin in a much-needed basket for East Lyme.
Yeah, good aggressive move that time by Anglin. Going to the rim, using the glass with the kiss. Good bucket.
Sproul kicks. Boone thought about it. But look how much the ball movement is better.
Yeah.
And there's a reach in steal. Anglin with Outlaw. Basket no good, but Will Anglin will go to the line and shoot two.
And Anglin going to the rim, using his body as a bit of a shield into Outlaw to try and get two. At least he's at the free throw line, Casey. And again, the bad turnover, the runout. That's what East Lyme wants. I think they kind of need that in this game, too.
Well, this is a huge, you know, circumstance change right now. We're going to have a mask break. And with the mask break, we will send it away and come on back. 17-11 NFA. You're watching Game Day Live on theday.com.
At The Day, our journalists are in your community, talking with business owners, attending town meetings, analyzing data, talking to government leaders, reporting on the issues that matter most to you. Since 1881, we have been serving our community and will continue to do so 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Never miss a day of news. Enjoy convenient home delivery right to your doorstep, 7 days a week. Subscribe at theday.com/membership.
Game Day is brought to you by Waterford Dental Health. At Waterford Dental Health, your smile and your health are our top priority. Well, we ask you, where are you watching the game? And here's your guy.
Vinny Hines.
Watching it at Dick's Sporting Goods. No shortage of supplies.
50% off. 50% off for Casey O'Neill.
I missed you. Oh. Oh, good to see you, Sports Doctor. So Anglin's at the line right now. He's got to knock these things down. Gets it down to a two possession game, but a closer, you know, it's a two possession game right now, but a little bit closer. I think East Lyme's got to turn the defense back up again. I think that was really NFA's just had too many good looks.
Yep.
50% off, he says. Why do I want to question where you got your kayak from, Sports Doctor?
Free sandwiches at Olive Oils, 50% off here and there.
Sports Doctor.
Hang with the Sports Doctor.
Post-COVID, I'm going to come on a route with you. I want to come on your route one day. I'm going to watch you at work. One more for Anglin. No good. Missed them both. That's a
foul shots.
Bad.
They were foul shots.
Not what he's looking for right there. East Lyme turning the defensive pressure up, though. Francis kicks out, and they will reset. Pierre-Louis kick. And no scorer on the floor right now, though. Boone with a floater, no good. And look at that rebound from Goose up ahead.
Got numbers.
Velacos finds Gaeta. Gaeta slashes to the basket. Great defense from Spruill. Got his body set and made Gaeta uncomfortable.
Gaeta got a caught in between there. Should I take it to the rim? Should I shoot a jump shot? A lot of rhythm.
Spruill and Goose takes the charge. Spruill went in hard. And that'll be a turnover. And Martin will check back into the ball game for NFA. And he will give Spruill a breather. You know what we haven't seen in this game from NFA is the big lineup, where Outlaw, Click, and Pierre-Louis are in the game
and
at the same,
and
are all in the same time.
Yeah, and Martin, yeah.
Because then when then you could slide Francis up high, and that could be that's a big lineup.
Kind of extending a little bit on DKC.
Yep, they need to be patient right now, do the Vikings. They need a good shot right here. There's a three in and out from Walsh, and Pierre-Louis goes high for the rebound.
That's a good look, though. It's a good shot from the corner. Lit on that rim the last couple trips for the Vikes.
Francis, baseline, hangs, gets his own rebound. Left hand, no good. Click, tips it out to Martin. Got Joe Click doing
hustling
offensive lineman work. Martin, crossover. Down low, Pierre-Louis. Gaeta ties him up.
Travel.
And we're going to get a jump ball. Possession arrow says it stays here, but that's good work from Marshall Gaeta tying up Pierre-Louis.
Yeah, I thought he kind of got him into a traveling situation. Looks like he picked up his pivot foot and tried to reset more than once.
Yeah, that's good defense. Good defense, however you slice it. And there's a miscommunication, almost an excuse me turnover,
yeah.
Martin, good defense from Velacos. Hangs in the air and can't finish. Goose rips it down and loses his mask in the process. Up ahead, and they're going to get it. Oh, that's a bad break for East Lyme. Goose has to come out because his mask broke, which negates the Gaeta layup in the other end. That's what they're saying.
Jeff Bernardi getting the explanation there from Roger Warner. You would think that they would have
a stack of masks.
A plethora of masks.
There should be a stack of masks, absolutely, available at any moment. So the good news is Goose gets a new mask and gets back in the game. Bad news for East Lyme, though, is Gaeta had a layup. They lost a layup. There's an open look and a swing, dump down, Gaeta spins, great defense. Gaeta puts it to the floor, left hand is strong. Marshall Gaeta will not be denied.
This kid's working hard, Casey. Second chance scoring opportunity, third chance scoring opportunity that time for Marshall Law, Marshall Gaeta. East Lyme again with only 5 points this quarter. The defense has kept him in it the last few trips.
Martin now, too much pounding of the basketball. Euro step, no good. Click, pours in. Velakis on the ground, but he gets it to Gaeta. Gaeta, up ahead it goes to Carpenteri. Blocked from behind, and he'll call a foul on Francis. And Chris Carpenteri will go to the line. Chance to make this a one possession game.
Well, the leak out and the run out has got East Lyme back into this ball game. They could be down by two after he makes both of these free throws, but you know, with the offense that's sputtering a little bit for Jeff Bernardi, the last few trips down, turnovers have led to offense for the Vikings.
Huge free throws here for the senior. Calmly knocks the first one down.
Nothing in net.
Yeah, Mundell and Anglin will check back in. No, he didn't hit any of the zone.
No.
And David Semnoski into the ball game, giving Gaeta a breather. I think they're going to let him run it out to the half. We said both teams would be content playing this game in the 30s.
Yeah, you ain't kidding.
If he makes this free throw, they're now both on pace to be above 30 in this game. And I want to make a.
And Mike DeMar with the overs, so.
Well, you know, we've talked. You know, sometimes there are ugly games like we've seen. This is not an ugly game. Nope. This is two very good defensive teams. Outlaw picks his dribble up. 30 seconds remaining, and Martin now with Anglin out on him. They're going to go for one shot. There goes Boone. Francis, baseline, hangs in the air, can't get it. Pierre-Louis Monami with a follow. Under 3 seconds, long three at the buzzer, no good. And we are at halftime, 19-15, NFA on top. And the sports doctor is going to talk with East Lyme's Jeff Bernardi, sports doctor.
Coach, you guys go in the locker room down by four, 19-15. How do you find a way to jumpstart your offense in a half-court set?
I don't think we're shooting with a ton of confidence right now. I think we're really hesitant. I think their length has something to do with that. They're quick to the ball. They're very long. But we just need to play a little bit more poise on the offensive end and shoot a little more confidence.
Are you happy with the defense and the rebounding out there?
It's easy to say yeah because we've given up 19. But they do have some second chance points I'd like to eliminate. And I think we've had like one or two breakdowns that we just can't afford in a game of this environment.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. Case?
All right, sports doctor. So the NFA dance team has been unable to appear at halftime this winter due to the COVID restrictions. So they sent us a performance, and then they sent us another one. So you know what? Enjoy the NFA dance team in this performance here at halftime.
Hey, yeah, I'm going to shoot, baby.
The day, our journalists are in your community, talking with business owners, attending town meetings, analyzing data, talking to government leaders, reporting on the issues that matter most to you. Since 1881, we have been serving our community and will continue to do so 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Never miss a day of news. Enjoy convenient home delivery right to your doorstep, 7 days a week. Subscribe at theday.com/membership.
19-15 the score here at halftime in the game of the year, so they say in the ECC. NFA leads East Lyme. I'm joined by my good friend Mike DeMauro. Mike, good basketball game here in the first half.
Yeah, Keith, as you and Case were saying, you know, just because sometimes when the games are low scoring and they're bad, this isn't. This has been a good one.
There's two very good defensive teams, and, you know, how do you crack the NFA zone? You know, how do you beat that man-to-man defense of East Lyme? I'll be curious to see how this game plays out. But, Mike, we talked about this week two or week three. You know, are these the teams that are going to start to separate themselves from the rest of the league? We've seen them all. You know, we've seen Waterford. We've seen Fitch. I believe these are probably two of the best teams. Maybe Fitch. But I think this is as good as it gets in the league.
I think these are the two best teams.
Yeah.
And with Fitch being on pause right now,
right.
until the 17th. I don't think there's any doubt these are the two best teams. I mean, they both, you know, after Fitch, you know, you got St. Bernard.
Right. And we'll see them tomorrow night.
Both of these teams have beaten them. So, and we will see them tomorrow night. But, yeah, no, these are the two best teams. And they, you know, they really do it with defense, which is not something you always see.
No. You said Casey referred to it as kids stepping across half court and looking to toe up a shot, yeah. Obviously, given
right.
Emily in the NBA. But these are two very well-coached teams, two disciplined coaches. Mike Christ-Juste, he was honored before the game.
Yeah.
25-game regular winning, you know, streak in the season. 23-0 last year. I think it was 8 or 9 years ago where he took that head coaching job. Won the ECC in his first year. Won it last year. You know, what can you say about Juice from coaching from year one to, say, coaching last year and this year?
Well, I think he's, you know, I think the main thing he's learned is that when you go from assistant to head coach, it goes from suggesting what to do to deciding what to do. And
right.
He's really come along. Done a great job, obviously. And you know.
So, Mike, I'm going to cut you off.
That's
but
okay.
I'm going to say that deciding what to do and making the tough decision as a head coach. Jared Martin came off the bench tonight. So if that doesn't tell you that not one player.
That's right.
Is bigger than his team, I think he delivered a good message.
It takes a lot of guts.
Takes
a lot
of guts
to do that. Yeah, yeah, and well, he's got those. We know that.
Right.
I mean, anybody who would wear what he's wearing tonight has guts.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, I could not pull that off. Well, anyway,
you could not. No, you couldn't.
Pull that.
You could not pull that off. You could not
no.
pull. Not many
anyway.
Can pull that look off. But you know, what yeah. kind of message does a head coach send? Not only is what is supposed to be a star player and the rest of his team by saying not only, you know what, you could sit this one out and then you can come off the bench.
He says, this is my show, not
right.
yours.
Right.
You know, and I you know, Keith, since we started the game day, we've seen several of our teams win state titles. And you just feel, I feel bad for Juice and the whole team that, We'll never know if that team last year could have finished.
Well,
it.
I tell you what, with the right draw, they could have been knocking on the door,
yeah,
at least
and,
being at the Mohegan Sun.
And we're seeing it now this year. And I think they played that 3-2 zone better
last year.
Better last
year. Yeah,
I agree. And for anyone who thinks that, you know, East Catholic or Windsor would have carved up that zone, just no way.
Yeah, I agree with you.
No way.
I agree with you.
NFA was really good last year.
Yeah, Mike, on the flip side real quick, we'll talk about East Lyme too. Again, 6-14 last year, 6-1 this year.
Just one word, Keith, discipline. It's so nice to see. It is so nice to see.
Yeah, Jeff's done a fantastic job.
Terrific.
With no real standout player.
Right.
You know
who's
the standout player?
Although...
Yeah, Gade is
getting there.
Gade is getting. You
he
know,
he might be player of the year right now.
You know who is a stand-up player? Casey O'Neill.
Well, we knew that already.
Casey is a
all right.
Mike, you're a stand-up player. Casey is a standout player. My good friend, my partner, Casey O'Neill. I'm gonna have a little fun with you in the second half too.
All right, sports.
We're gonna have a little fun in the second half.
All right,
we're gonna talk about a lot of different things here. Good ball game here. Let's see the adjustments made. Coming out to start second half.
I think East Lyme, and you know, Jeff Bernardi at the half said it. I don't think he liked his defense. I think we thought, you know, I think he's disappointed. I think they need to turn him over a little bit more. And then they got to stop turning it over offensively. Carpenteri for three, no good. Oh, why is Gaeta? There's the open kick. Dump back to Gaeta.
Go to work.
Goose. Baseline, they're determining. Once you take Gaeta out of the game, there's not a lot there. Goose in the lane, can't get it to go. Pierre-Louis with a strong rebound.
Yeah, too congested, not enough spacing. Spread the floor a little bit.
Without their inability to knock down outside shots, I mean, they're not hard to play defensively because of that. Spruill kicks. Martin launches the first three of the second half and buries it.
Yep. on cue. 14 for number 11. The big bucket come out to start second half.
And there's a steal by Martin going the other way. Jump step, left-handed layup. And NFA has gone J-Mart shopping to start the second half. It's a 9-point lead.
5-0 run, Casey. Jared Martin show. Knocked down a three, a little leak out. 2 points at the rim.
Here's the thing.
Danger zone time for East Lyme. Don't have a guy that can rise up and score a bunch of points.
Yeah, I said that NFA has the highest ceiling of anybody in the league. And it all depends on whether Jared Martin lets the game come to him or if he forces his presence into the game.
Yeah, you see here, Casey, you're going to see Martin in full control. The run out, the strip, the delivery at the rim, the easy two that time, a little shake and bake two for Jared Martin. And again, you talked about him. The pounding of the basketball, not good. Catch and shoot and rhythm. Get out on a break, get yourself an easy look. That's scoring in a flow and in a rhythm.
If Jared Martin treats it like he's one of the guys, and when the shots are there, he takes them, this team is going to be lights out. When he feels that burden to sort of assert himself, the threes from half court and the pounding the ball, that's when they get out of their rhythm because they're so good defensively. That when he's in the flow of things like he is right now, they become beastly. And East Lyme on the other side, they're going to have to get Will Anglin and Riley Walsh opportunities for a couple threes because otherwise not a lot there. Velakos pulls up and knocks down a 12-footer. That's a big basket.
Yeah, it's very eerie of the St. Bernard's game, Casey, because the game was very close. Then Martin started to cook, and NFA took it over. It's got the same feel as it.
What I want to see right now is Martin there, step back three, no good. Gets his own rebound, drives baseline, hangs in the air, and he'll go to the line.
Oh, he's working.
But I was just about to say, I want to see if after he goes 5-minute row, if he goes back in, and he did. He took an ill-advised step back shot. The opportunity was there to get back into the flow of things. Now, to his credit.
He hustled for it.
He hustled for it.
Got his own.
Now he's at the line. Yes, yes. It's tough because he does have the talent to be the best player on the floor.
When you're knocking him down, Casey, you want to let it rip whenever you get hands on it. It's a slippery slope. I mean, you've coached kids. When you're feeling a little bit, you just want to let it ride.
That's what you told me at Nathan Hale's school when we played Mikey Bassetto. You made one shot.
Yeah.
You said, I'm feeling it now. Yeah. Give me the rock. There's a good swing over to Boone. Pierre-Louis hands it off out low, strong to the basket, hangs in the air and scores.
Yeah, big boy move right there time by Ryan Outlow. Just good, strong take to the rim. Head down and go. Football coach has got to like that one.
They're going to have Coach Bakulis doing leg day every day.
Boy.
Dump down, stripped. Outlow comes away with the ball and gives it up to Boone. There goes Pierre-Louis, tried to find Martin. Walsh with the strip, 2-on-1. Hangs in the air, can't get it to fin it, can't get it to go down, and it'll be tipped. NFA basketball.
Right now, East Lyme out of sorts. It's kind of like that, a little danger zone time for Jeff Benardi and the Vikings. NFA's playing with a lot more energy and a lot more aggression right now.
Outlow bullies his way to the basket, hangs, can't score, and a strong rebound. Turnover, though. Underneath, Martin puts it to the floor, hangs in the air. Oh, Pierre-Louis, c'est magnifique! 11-point lead for the Wildcats.
A 9-2 run to start the second half.
Gata, baseline jumper. He was contested by Outlow. Gets it back. Can't get that one to go. And Mad Max with the strong rebound. Oh, look at the fancy dribbling from Boone, but he turns it over. Velakis out of the pack. Ahead it goes to Goose. Layup is good, and the foul on Outlaw, and he'll go to the line. Much needed hoop in the harm for the Vikings.
Goose is on the loose. Pattern is not full, Ghost Rider. To the rim. Again, that defense that leads to offense, the sloppy play on one end and the leak out on the other end. We have a mask break.
We have a mask break and a 9-point NFA lead. Come back on the other side on theday.com. Brought to you by Waterford Dental Health. Our entire team is dedicated to providing you the personalized, convenient, and affordable dental care you and your family deserve. 177 Boston Post Road in Waterford. That's Waterford Dental Health. Where are you watching the game? Well, we've got a happy Jaden Francis fan, number 3 all the way for NFA. Jaden Francis, and you know what? Let's talk a little bit about him because I think that his maturation over the course of this year has taken this team when he's playing with the confidence that he's playing with right now. That big three that he hit against Fitch, you think that's the kind of thing that launches you into that confidence zone?
Yeah, is it glue guy, Casey, that steps up a little bit when it's called upon? Be ready because your number is going to be called. And that's a great point. He kind of goes underneath the radar a little bit, but he makes plays. You know, he makes plays on a defensive end. He can knock down some shots. And the one thing about Francis, he's very unselfish.
He is, and it's funny because in the pregame warm-ups, you know, everyone's watching click dunk and Max dunk. Francis throwing him down, too.
Yeah.
He's a really athletic kid, and he's asked to do very little, you know, in terms of fanfare, but he's starting to play with a lot of confidence, getting to the rim, making passes, plays good defense. Click hangs in the air, and a great rebound, Vlachos. Boy, Click can really run. Kick out, baseline jump shot, no good from Walsh, and look at Click with a rebound. Martin. Martin hangs, and he's stripped from behind.
Got a run out here.
Vlachos, he'll push. Stripped from behind by Spruill. Now NFA has numbers. Martin for 3, no good. Pierre-Louis on the rebound, weak side. So Spruill with the basketball. There's Click, goes baseline on Gaeta. Good defense, he kicks to Martin. Martin, long 3, got it! Jared Martin from downtown.
That is from deep, that is from Preston that time. 19 for Jared Martin.
East Lyme.
Where are they going to find their offense, Casey? Where is it going to come from? How do you crack this zone?
There's a dump down Gaeta, and he loses the basketball. Big turnover, going the other way now. Spruill, NFA, putting the clamps on the Vikings.
East Lyme is 5 points in the second half, in the third quarter.
There's Francis, drives, hangs, and finishes.
Well, there's your guy. The glue guy at the rim, Francis.
Yeah, I really like Jaden Francis. The seniors playing with so much more confidence, and he really, when you got Click and Francis and guys like,
isn't that something? You get Click one night, you're going to get Francis the next. So they're picking each other up.
Straightaway 3 from Walsh is good. Riley Walsh burying the 3.
Had to have that. Catch and shoot, find the open player, and Juice is upset. There's a wide open look from 3, calls a full timeout. He's hot. Coach is hot.
Well, I think what he's saying is they got one guy who can shoot the basketball. One guy you don't want to leave open is Riley Walsh, right? So anybody else?
That's what he's saying. He's yelling one guy, huh?
Like, I mean, it's listen, I'm no John Wooden, but
no.
You don't have to be to figure out. There's one guy on the team that knocks down threes for them. Let Carpentieri shoot it. Right? Let Vlahos shoot it. Gaeta's only going to work down on the baseline. It's Riley.
You got
Walsh.
One guy. You got it. You cannot leave him unaccountable on the floor.
And
you
it was, on a,
where
and
he
it was
is.
On a it's on a kickout.
Yep.
Give the two.
Right.
Not the kickout for three.
Right.
Not to mention, you got Click and Outlaw and Pierre Louis and those guys. They can handle themselves down there.
Yeah, especially in a one-on-one situation.
Right.
Absolutely.
You don't have to slide down and give help like that. So I think that's what he's saying. On the other side, Coach Bernardi, I love the composure, right? Very calm. We're not going to get rattled. One possession at a time.
Well, I think that's true in this game right here. One possession at a time.
It's 10 right now. Here's what I'm going to say. If it's 10 or more going into the fourth quarter, it finishes at 20. If it's eight or less going into the fourth quarter, we got a game.
Yeah.
We got a game. And I say that because NFA has got the ball. So the difference in going up 12 or 13 versus going up 8 is a huge.
Right.
Oh, good defense. Good defense by Anglin.
Turnover,
knocked it off the leg of Martin, and with 1:17 remaining, East Lyme. Now they got Mundell into the ball game, so we'll see if he's a shooter as well. They might be looking for a little more in the shooting arena right now. Down the baseline, they tried to swing to Gaeta.
Careful with the ball, though. You got to throw him that basketball where you can catch it, Casey, and Gaeta's got to make himself a little more available.
You also have to recognize before you get the pass whether that's there or not.
Yeah.
He just passed it.
That wasn't there.
And it really wasn't there. Nice look. Gaeta had a wide open look, but Martin stepped in the way and – back-to-back turnovers. East Lyme really needed a shot there. Martin. No good. Gets his own rebound and finishes. Jared Martin's second effort.
Putting on a show. That's just out-hustling East Lyme. Again, when you got Goose on the bench and Vlahos on the bench, who picks up the slack for the Vikings on the boards?
Little 2-1-2 set for East Lyme. Gaeta spins.
That's a good move. That's a good move.
I like this 2-1-2 set against the 3-2. Spread it out, create your triangles.
That's a good drop step move by the big man, though. That's a great basketball move.
Under 20 seconds remaining. Martin's going to get the last shot off. Make sure that NFA goes in no worse than 10. Pull up, three, blocked. Up ahead, great job. Francis intercepted it, he pulls up for three. No good, Martin with a tip. And we're gonna get Martin over the back of Mundell with 1 second remaining. So a lot of action and no real results from it. East Lyme will have a chance to get off a desperation shot here at the end of the third period, down 10. There it is, at the buzzer, good if it goes, no good. We're at the end of three, 10-point NFA lead. You're watching Game Day live on theday.com.
Okay, class. What do you want to be when you grow up? Jace.
I want to be a YouTuber.
I want to be a ballerina.
I want to be an astronaut.
I want to be homeless.
I want to hear scary voices no one else can hear.
I want to be addicted to drugs.
I want to be an actress.
Not one child has dreams of these things becoming a reality. Sometimes choices are set before we even have a voice.
With Sound Community Services, I found my voice.
Sports Doctor is going to be down on the floor real quick with Chris Giusti.
Coach, you guys are up by 10. What's the one thing you have to do to finish this game out?
Take care of the basketball.
Good luck down the stretch, Coach.
Dude,
<All right.
laughs>
Hey, plain and simple. Got to take care of the basketball. NFA will inbound. Listen, sometimes verbose is unnecessary. Easy question, easy answer. Let's get into the fourth quarter action. Click. Out to Outlaw. They got the bully unit in. Click, Outlaw, and Pierre Louis. This is the bully unit in there right now. They're going to try to get to the basket any chance they can. Hey, sometimes you don't need to ask long questions. You don't need long answers. What do you need to do? Protect the ball. Here we go. Let's go.
Simple. He'll turn the ball over, and then,
He appreciated the short question.
Too. Yes.
That's a great look.
Good look.
Pierre-Louis.
Now the set piece and the movement without the basketball by Pierre-Louis Casey and the delivery at the rim, the kid could go up and get it.
Gata, there's the kick out. Balakos pulls up over Pierre-Louis, no good. Look at Max go up and get it. And NFA, 12-point lead and the basketball. Oh, there's a steal. Carpentieri smartly, wisely pulls it out. Open three, no good. Goose with the rebound. And a little baseline jumper, no good. Click. Quick.
Slam can't buy one tonight, can they? Everything.
They're not a great shooting team. They Gata around the basket, a lot of off, you know, transition baskets off the defense. But they're not a great shooting team, which is, even against Ledger, when we saw them push Ledger, it was all about transition baskets, defense creating offense. Mm. Defensively, they're fabulous. They really are. But they're not a great shooting team. And Walsh can shoot it, but really they rely on shots around the basket, second efforts, and transition. And not every team does everything well, you know? There's a turnover. Now Click coming the other way. Oh, and somehow...
What was going on down there? First and 10 from the 30?
That was fumble Ruski.
Yeah.
Balakos gets himself in trouble. Gata at the foul line. No good. Outlaw with a big rebound.
And NFA done a much better job here in the last, say, quarter and a half, two quarters of securing the basketball on the defensive end. No second chance opportunities to go off East Lyme.
I think East Lyme is one legit shooter, as Chris Giusti wants a timeout. I think East Lyme is one legit shooter away from being an impossible team to defend.
Right.
Take a guy, I mean, pick any team in the league and give me one shooter off of that team. You know, I don't care, take Bacon Academy, take Montville. One guy who can simply stand on the wing and knock down shots. Because if you had Riley Walsh on one side and that kid on the other side.
Right. With Gata down low, kicking and dealing the goods a little bit, yeah.
But right now, you know, you can play zone. You can let Gata, you know, you can play Gata and just don't let Walsh drift alone. And they're not a great perimeter team. They're easier to defend, but they're one shooter away from being special.
And I don't know if it's the NFA defense, but to me, East Lyme looks a half a step slow tonight on offense. I watched them play in person the other night against Waterford Casey, and that ball moved. They were crisp. They got their way around the court in a half-court set, and maybe we don't give NFA's defense too much credit, but they look a little bit slow tonight.
You mean we don't give them enough credit?
Enough credit, yeah.
No, I think you're right. I think you're right.
I mean, because that game against Waterford, I saw them dissect the Lancers.
Nothing against Bill Bassett or Waterford's version of the 3-2.
They don't have the horses.
No.
They don't have the horses.
We said you can't duplicate the length of Outlaw, Pierre-Louis, Martin. You can't duplicate the quickness of Boone and Spruill. But really, it's Max. Max might be the most singularly unique athlete in the ECC. Look, a little weave now. Boone, Spruill, and Martin with a little weave.
Burn some clock, get a good shot.
Taking a page out of New London High School's book back in the 90s. They used to weave people to death with the lead. There's a good hands. Balakos comes out of it. And he'll go up strong. And how'd that not go down? Gata, though, finishes. They can't get that to go down. Again, Balakos.
Four for a dollar.
What a defensive possession for NFA. East Lyme clearly put a lid on the basket.
Yes. Four for a buck right there. My goodness. Jeff Bernardi frustrated, hands on his hips.
You know what that reminded me of? Remember ski ball?
Yeah. Try to get the top.
And no matter what you did, you couldn't get it to go. Yeah. It would bounce off the side every
100.
Time.
Yeah.
That was ski ball right there.
Are you dating yourself?
I am. Sports doctor, the one good thing I have is that I will never be as old as you.
Never.
Gata turns it over. Pierre-Louis out of the pack with Click. Oh, look at the heads-up play from the big
Click.
Man.
Yeah.
He said, coach said we're running the football. Yeah. Martin, there you go. There you go. If you're gonna,
Chris Drewski's mask would have came off if that shot would have went off.
Coachable. Fakes the three. They're gonna burn some clock.
Yeah, they're gonna burn clock.
Gonna make East Lyme come out and play. Layups only. Eventually, you should
East
get Lyme's
a backdoor. Eastline's going to have to start doubling.
You should get a backdoor cut out of this eventually. There's a high screen from Click.
Or three.
Martin pulls up three, in and out. But, oh, nobody found Francis.
There's your backdoor cut, Case, right there, Francis.
That's sort of demoralizing when you let up something like that. Walsh with a long three, tip Carpenterian. I want to check.
East Lyme has had some point blank shots.
I want to check the circumference of that basket.
Yeah. My goodness.
Under 4 minutes remaining, East Lyme will just have to pressure. You know, if we get some pressure on the ball, the NFA will just sit on it. Sproul with Velakos. Now in the corner goes to Francis.
East Lyme's going to start selling out, double teaming here eventually.
We're going to get a reach in. Riley Walsh.
Look at his second team foul against the Vikings. So if you're looking at a one-on-one situation, you still got five more fouls to give with 3:25 to go.
And we've got a mask break. So with a 14-point NFA lead, we're going to send it out. We'll come on back. You're watching Game Day Live on theday.com.
The Day strives to cover stories our readers care about. With a feature called Curious CT, we make it easier for you to tell us what you want to know about the people, places, and issues in southeastern Connecticut. You submit a question, readers vote, and we investigate and report. Go to theday.com/curiousct for more details. You ask, you vote, we investigate.
Game Day is brought to you by Waterford Dental Health. At Waterford Dental Health, great smiles start there. Waterford Dental Health, 177 Boston Post Road in Waterford.
Ah, there you go.
There's some smiles. Oh, the hair's getting long. It's COVID hair.
Yep. Peter, you ever grow hair like that? You ever have hair like Mason's Pete, our broadcaster?
Yes, one time.
When you were in undergrad college?
Or what?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was rite of passage stuff. We all had to do it. Martin hangs Dipsy Doo for two.
That's a good move that time. That's a basketball move. That's a scorer's move that time by Martin. The step in, the switch to the right. 23 points, the little finger will touch at the rim.
And Pierre-Louis comes out and blocks the shot. And Martin wisely holds up.
Chris Giusti put the brakes on in front of him. Hold it out.
Stutter steps. NFA will just try to milk this thing for a little while now.
I might be wrong when I say this, but I don't think East Lyme has scored in this quarter yet, have they?
No.
Mike, can you help me out with that? I don't think East Lyme has scored in this quarter. They have not.
Francis to the basket, offensive foul. He's going to use the left with the elbow. Another NBA move.
So
Coach Giusti didn't like that.
Yeah, he didn't like that at all. Give your shout out to Marcus Outlaw. He has got the shoes on tonight. He's rocking it over there.
Well, I gave him
NFA bunch over there showed up big time tonight.
Yeah, I gave Marcus grief after the Fitch game. I said, "What, are we going to sweatshirts now? What happened?" I think he was a little upset. I go, "You got the wardrobe. You got to use it."
Yeah, they look good over there. Oh, yeah. The whole NFA staff and Marcus Outlaw with the shoes and the
sweater. He's got the sneakers on tonight, though. I like that. Well, that's because he's paced
There's
around
Marcus
there.
Right there.
And the socks, too.
Oh, he's back in the swing of things, huh?
That's right. NFA says, look the game, play the game. And there's nice
first basket.
Down.
First basket of the fourth quarter came in at the 2:10 mark. 10 points for Gator.
Going to get a foul out on the perimeter. Riley Walsh tripped Sproul, and Sproul will.
Yep. 12 points in the second half for East Lyme.
Yeah, we talked about the East Lyme defense, and it's a good defense, but the NFA defense has been, pretty.
Smothering.
That's a good word for it. That's exactly right. That's what they've been.
Nothing down low. Gator doesn't have a lot of room to work, and the 3-point line, they come out and rushing that, and Giusti saw one 3-pointer and called timeout.
Outlaw hangs. Reverse layup is good. Nice move by Ryan Outlaw. Walsh, long 3-pointer. Got it. Man, that kid can shoot the basketball.
Yeah.
Riley Walsh.
Juicy's still over there screaming, one guy. Screaming to Jared Martin, one guy can beat us.
And it's a kick out. They keep wanting to call apps. So let's take a moment with the 13-point NFA lead to look at tomorrow night. We'll be at the brand new gym on the hill, St. Bernard's High School, as they play host to their old rival, the New London High School Whalers. Yeah. When you were last week, when you were gone, Mike DeMauro said to me, he goes, did those two teams really hate each other as much as they did. Oh, yeah. So you got to go back into, you know, the formation of St. Bernard's at a time when New London was the premier school. And the conferences that those schools played in, you know, New London was playing in the Hartford Conference, and St. Bernard's, yeah, you know, was, and then there's the Catholic Conference.
Sure.
There were so many teams. But St. Bernard's New London in the 80s.
Yeah, pretty dynamic.
Was like North Carolina Duke.
Yeah.
Where,
yeah,
you know, when Harold Presley showed up at the John T. Conway Gymnasium.
He wasn't that bad, huh?
And Greg Hall dunked over him three times.
Oh, okay, here we go. Back to the New London reference.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Hey, listen. those banners don't
lie. It's the green and gold standard, as you would say.
Yeah, the banners don't lie. We're going to get a turnover here as the possession arrow favors East Lyme, and they tied up Francis. The point, though, was that rivalry over the years has kind of faded away, but tomorrow night, with all the guard play we're going to see, it should be an entertaining game. Oh, there's a steal. Martin ahead of the pack in the other direction. And he finishes at the rim. Three ball side pocket is good from Carpenteri. Sproul with the basketball for NFA, and they have a comfortable 12-point lead here as we're down under a minute remaining in the game. East Lyme content not to foul. And they're going to let the clock run down here. They're going to play some solid defense. There goes Sproul.
This is a good win for the Wildcats. This is a good win.
And with this win, ironically, it puts Fitch up at the top of the conference with one loss, even though Fitch is in the midst of a quarantine.
Casey, this game was 19-15 at halftime. I think you saw with having a score like Jaron Martin does for your team in the second half. I mean, play a good 5-to-5-second count there. But a good, good defensive effort. And then a guy who can step up, and then you sprinkle in Francis. Now, Outlaw, they get a contribution from everybody, but they do have the best player on the floor.
Well, that's like I said, the reason why their ceiling is the highest ceiling is without Jared Martin, they're still an incredibly good defensive team. They're still, you know, ahead of the pack with teams. But with him on the floor and him in the flow of the game, they can do things that no other team can do. So, you know, without Martin, they're outstanding defensively. They're gritty. They're physical.
Right.
They can rebound. With him playing selfishly.
Well, you hit the nail on the head. You said flow of the game.
With him selfishly, they're
stagnant. Yes.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Well,
you go.
When he's in the flow
he's
of the game.
Pounding, and you got four guys sitting around watching.
That's right.
But when he's running, wheeling, and dealing, the team's cooking a little
and
bit
nobody
out there.
And nobody can match
no.
their combination of defense and offense, because that was the one knock. When he's selfish or not, and he's pounding the ball,
right,
they don't score.
No.
But when he's in the flow of the game, now they're scoring points. Under 20 seconds remaining. Outlaw dumped down. Pierre-Louis will pick it off by Velacos. Gato will come out ahead. Three ball, no good, tipped. And that'll come down into the hands of NFA, and that'll wind out the clock. 45-33. Come on back on the other side. The Sports Doctor will have Chris Giusti and the Waterford Dental Health Player of the Game. You're watching Game Day Live on theday.com.
At the Day, our journalists are in your community, talking with business owners, attending town meetings, analyzing data, talking to government leaders, reporting on the issues that matter most to you. Since 1881, we have been serving our community and will continue to do so 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Never miss a day of news. Enjoy convenient home delivery right to your doorstep, 7 days a week. Subscribe at theday.com/membership.
Twelve-point win for NFA. The Sports Doctor has Coach Chris Giusti. Sports Doctor,
Well, Coach, first of all, a big effort tonight by your kids. You preach defense all year long. You held this team almost 6 minutes into fourth quarter without a basket. Talk about your defensive play down the stretch of this game.
Yeah, I mean, I told the guys, no matter what defense we play, it has to be with passion and energy. And we practice man-to-man a lot in practice. And, you know, we just happen to have personnel right now that can bother teams with that big front, Max at the top. But really, it's man-to-man principles. It's switching man principles, talking, knowing where people are. You saw me. I got hot a couple times.
Sure, yeah.
Because we lost the guy that we were
trying
to focus
right?
on.
One guy.
Yeah, so, I mean, that's something that we have to get better at. But, you know, this league, Coach Bernardi said it, you know, the last week, this league is going to be based on defense. And on any given night, a team that gets hot, we hit a couple deep threes that kind of, oh, we could exhale a little bit. Before that, it looked like the under was definitely going to win. But it still might have won.
Coach,
but what a performance by those guys. They really laid it all on the line tonight.
You know, one thing about your team, if you're, you know, a couple games, you're getting, you know, 13 from click. Tonight you had a kid like Francis step up and play big. Kind of flies under the radar a little bit. But talk about some of the players that don't get the limelight, the glue guys for your team.
Jaden Francis, senior. Tyler Spruill, senior. Joe Click, senior. Jared Martin, senior. That's what they're supposed to do. That's what they came here to do. They went through. Some of them got to play varsity a little earlier than others.
Sure.
But when you're a senior, there's only one option, varsity, and there's a standard, and they met that standard tonight.
Coach, one last question. You talk about teams getting hot at the right time. I know we got a couple games left to go in the regular season. Do you like the makeup of this team right now heading into the tournament play in a couple weeks?
Yeah, I like it. We kind of stumbled, and then we got hit with the cancellation. So I don't know if we could get anything better than the 3 seed, unfortunately. But we just got to play the game in front of us and see what happens.
You never let us down here on game day, but you know, Casey was asking me, is it too early to wear white? It's not quite Memorial Day. It's after Labor Day. Show the cameras at home.
This is a tribute to the great Howard Dickeman Sr., who coached here in the 40s, 50s, early 60s at NFA. He was the all-time winningest coach until Neil Curlin eclipsed that winning record a few years back. And he always wore the bow tie.
All right.
So I wanted to do it one time. Rest in peace, Coach D.
Coach, we'll see you soon. Great win tonight. Good job by your kids.
Thank you.
All right, sports doctor. So that was Coach Chris Giusti and a tribute to Howie Dickeman. And we're going to bring in the Waterford Dental Health player of the game, Jared Martin. And the sports doctor will have an opportunity to speak with him after a 12-point victory tonight. And the Jared Martin, the Waterford Dental Health player
Waterford
of the game.
Waterford Dental Health player of the game, Jared Martin, all smiles underneath your mask. Jared, first of all, I got to ask you, how did it actually feel to come off the bench tonight?
It didn't feel so good because, like, I'm usually starting the game off, but when they bring energy, I'm straight. I come off the bench and do what I got to do.
Now, at what point of the game did you let the game come to you? And when you let the game come to you, good things start to happen. So is it just a natural flow of the game? You knock down a three. What's the scorer's mentality when that starts happening?
I start off with layups first. Yeah, once I make a layup, I'm good with everything. I'm straight.
Okay, now look, we got a couple games left to go in this season. How good can this team be? Have we seen the best basketball out of this team, or are you guys ready for more?
We're ready for more. This is not the best we can do. We can beat any team. I feel like we can beat any team out here.
Right. Great job tonight. Very, very unselfish from you and all your teammates tonight. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah.
All right, Jared Martin. He's our Waterford Dental Health player of the game. 25 points tonight. Casey.
Jaden Francis, Max Pierre-Louis, Grover Boone, Spruill. Outlaw all over to congratulate the Waterford Dental Health player of the game, Jared Martin. A much, much more reserved Jared Martin. I think a Jared Martin that understands his importance to this team. If they want to be a great team, it means maybe he doesn't. As soon as he realizes that to be a great team, he can still be a great player.
Yeah.
But it doesn't necessarily have to be the shiny penny, so to speak. He needs to be in the flow of the game. We saw it tonight. I thought this was a much better effort. This is the best effort we've seen from NFA.
I would agree 1,000%. I mean, better than St. Bernard's, better than Fitch.
they played really well. The defense really, again, they held East Lyme almost scoreless for the first six minutes of the fourth quarter. And then when you got a kid that can actually do some work on the offensive end when the game naturally comes to him, it's pretty good. You know, the one thing I didn't ask Chris Giusti, and I should have, was, you know, how is the vibe around a team when you're telling them you're bringing your star player off the bench? That's probably should have been something I should have asked him, but I got caught up in his outfit. So,
well, I can't blame him. That was great. A good tribute to Howie Dickman. Yeah, yeah. So, I think what's important to note is that NFA really loves when game day shows up.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
I mean, they beat St. Bernard's.
Right.
Right, who has only got two losses, that one of them. They beat Fitch. Give them their first loss.
Sure.
They beat East Lyme to give East Lyme their second loss.
Yeah.
So, you know, they've played big on game day, but I think what it shows is, sure, there's that parity in the league, and you have to play better than, you know, you have to play, obviously, you have to play better than the other team.
Yeah, right, right.
But, no, you have to play better than just the kind of, like, you can't give a C effort. C effort, you're going to lose. Well, you have
I'm looking over at Jeff Bernardi over my shoulder here, and I think that's what he's telling his team right now. You can't, you know, expect to win a game like this. We have to match their intensity. And I think tonight NFA had their intensity up here, and East Lyme was kind of in the middle.
Yeah, and it's easy to look at energy levels and intensity, and I think you're right. But the other team, you know, when you line up across from Joe Klick and he kicks your butt for three quarters, it's not intensity. Yeah, it's the sheer force of will. I don't think East Lyme lacked intensity. I think NFA began to assert its will on East Lyme. And moving forward,
And with that said, though, East Lyme got frustrated. Yes. I mean, that's naturally what happens. Yeah. I mean, you're taking away the things that we do. You're taking away Gator. Obviously, we can't hit the three-pointer, so you press a little bit.
There is nothing more frustrating in all of sports than giving your best effort and having someone else beat you.
That's true.
I mean, when you can say it's great, it's a good feeling to know you gave your best.
Right.
But when you give your best and that guy dunks over you anyway, or you give your best and the guy puts a fastball by you anyway, it's disheartening. I think there were moments tonight where East Lyme had players say, I'm doing everything I can, and I just, you know, they're still
stuck in quicksand a little bit. It's that feeling. But listen, this is going to be an interesting couple games in the season. We'll get a chance to see East Lyme one more time against Waterford next Monday night. I'm sure we'll see NFA again, and, you know, the tournament's going to be a lot of fun.
You know, tomorrow night at St. Bernard's, in New London, two lost teams that I think are both in the mix as far as the tournament's concerned. Yep. I think both of them. I said earlier in the year, and you agreed with me, that six different teams could make the finals of the ECC.
Yeah.
I have no reason to believe that that's not the case. I believe there are six teams that could make the finals of the ECC final this year.
The green and gold standard tomorrow night.
So join us tomorrow night at St. Bernard's High School on the Hill, New London High School Whalers, traveling up Route 32 to go play the Saints. Mark Jones' Saints there at St. Bernard's in the new gymnasium. We're looking forward to seeing that. For Peter Wappy and the crew, Mike DeMauro, and my guy, the sports doctor, I am Casey O'Neill, saying good night, everybody.